Debugging is one of the most important activity which developers do, you know, on a daily basis, right? And lots of times, you know, what happens is you want to debug something, but you don't want to debug everything. Again, I repeat, lots of times, you know, you want to debug something, but you don't want to debug everything. Means what? For example, you can see that we have a very, very simple for loop here, which actually loops 100 times. And this for loop actually makes a call to method 1 and to method 2. Now, what I want to do is I want to actually go and debug this for loop, but I want to debug only method 2. So, in other words, I want that the debugger should go into method 2 here like this, but I don't want that the debugger should actually go inside method 1. So, even though if I put a debug point here, I'm not really interested to go inside method 1. So, in other words, if you see in our, if we just run this normally, what will happen? When I go in method 1, it will actually go and debug inside. And when I go in method 2, it actually goes and debug inside, right? But what I want is that, you know, I want him to not step into method 1. I just want him to step into method 2. So, in other words, I just want him to step into method 2, but I don't want him to step into method 1. So, I don't want this thing, right? So, how do we handle this? So, that's why we have this magical attribute called as DebuggerStepThrough. So, if you go and decorate that method or the property or that logic, you know, whatever it is, with this attribute DebuggerStepThrough, what will happen is the debugger will not step into method 1 now. Now, this DebuggerStepThrough attribute actually belongs to the namespace system.diagnostics. So, you have to ensure that this namespace is imported into your solution. So, if I now go and run this, so if I do F5, and now I'm doing a F11, so you can see now the time I do a F11, it does not go inside this, it actually goes into method 2. So you can see now my debugger is not stepping into method 1, even though if I have a debug point here, he is not stepping into method 1, right? So lots of time, you know, when we do debugging, you know, and we want to ensure that unnecessary debuggings are not happening or debug throughs are not happening, you can just go and decorate this attribute and make your debugging life easy. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what is the use of this DebuggerStepThrough attribute. Thank you so much.